Okay, so this is going to be an explanation of what I showed you guys in the class earlier, where we talked about using Git and version control. I am also going to do a quick run through about showing how you would go about running a project from start. So, like I said previously, all of my projects work the same way. So if I'm starting at home, I would CD into development. And then if I do an LS, it shows all the projects that I'm working on. So while I'm here, I'm going to make a directory. Let's call it Saturday, right? And then I'm going to CD into that directory. And if we do an LS, there's nothing in there. Now, what I'm going to do next is set up my virtual environment by doing Python 3-m, Python 3-m, venv. Basically, I'm saying I want to create the virtual environment right here. We give it a moment. It has created, and we know it's created because if I do an ls, you would see all these the bin folder and all the supporting folders being created. Next thing, I'm going to make another directory, and I'm going to call it Saturday. Let's call that Saturday. CD into that. And our directory is now created, and we know it's done because there's nothing in it. And that is it for the part of the initial setup, where we have created a virtual environment, and then we have also created a directory in which we are going to put our project. Okay, so the next thing we want to do now is we want to go to GitHub. And you would go to github.com, and then you would log in. And if you don't have an account, you would create an account. But I already have an account, and I am already logged in because I spend a lot of time in here. And the first thing we want to do is you want to go to the upper right hand corner, and I don't know if you can see my mouse, but you want to select the caret next to the plus sign, and then we want to do create a new repository. When you do create new repository, you want to give that repository a name. So in this case, we are going to call this repository Sunday. And then we know it's good because there is a green check mark that means that it accepts that name. And then I'm going to give it a description, which we are going to say rerun of the GitHub explanation and workflow. And we are going to leave the access settings on this for public. Leave it at public because we don't want, if we set it at private to private, then you are expected to pony up and you don't want that. And then the next thing we want to check is we want to add a README file. That README file will basically take this description and add it to it. And once you have that, all we have to do at that point is create a repository. And our repository is now created. We can tell because we have that README.md, our repository name, rerun of the GitHub explanation and workflow, which is what I put in the description. So we are going to now do this. We are going to now go to code, click on that, and we want to click on the clipboard to copy whatever is in there. And we copy that, and that's the end of that for as far as what we are going to do on github.com. Okay, so now that we have our repo cloned, we can see here that we have that one file, the one file that is part of the stuff we cloned. Let's make it interesting by creating a couple of empty files. So I'm gonna do touch the file.txt, touch the file.py, touch a file. YAML. And if we do ls, we now see that we have the files we just created. So because I use Powerline shell, I get to get the feedback as to things haven't changed right away. You guys don't have that. So to verify that things have changed, you would do git status and you get the feedback right there that says that these files have been added, but they are not being tracked. These are unversioned files. So to start tracking those files, you would want to do git status. Oh, you want to do git add star. This will add everything. And now if you do git status, we see it that there's a color change for our untracked files. They are now being tracked, so they are now in, they now have this green color. Now, but that is all local to this machine. It's not yet been pushed to GitHub. So to make these changes permanent, first of all, we need to commit them. So we're going to do a git commit dash m, and then we are going to say added three files. All right. And that has committed those changes, but again, that committing is on the local, it's local to this machine. It's not yet been pushed to the remote repository on GitHub. So now, what we want to do now would be to do a git push origin main. And then it asks for my password, or for my username, and we're going to do that. And the password. I hear that password authentication has now been deprecated. I've just not had the chance to look into what you need to use instead. But now we can now see that our change has been, our three files have been moved, have been committed to GitHub. And how do we know that? If we do a git status, we see that there are no files which need to be committed. It says that your branch is up to date with original master. So, sorry about that. Gotta get those, get that fresh water in. So, now let's move to the next phase. All right, so now if we come here to our GitHub page, or if we come back to our GitHub page, we now have this repository. If everything worked correctly, and I refresh, we should see the three files that we created. they have now been merged into the code base from our PC. So we now have our three files. Okay, so let's say we go back to a clean screen, and then you do an ls and we have these files, right? I am going to, let's modify the text file. So let's do a pip list, and then we'll pipe that into the file dot text, right? And if we do a cat on the file dot text, we can see that there is some output inside that file, which definitely tells me that there has been some modification to the file, right? And we can also tell by the fact that main is no longer green. But for you guys, you would do a git status, and it basically tells you that a file.txt has been modified, right? So we can go ahead and commit it. Git commit dash -am added contents to a file dot text, right? And we have inserted 257 items into that file, but again, that is all local. So if we do a git push origin main, we have to enter our username and password. And everything looks good. But what happens if you want to refer it? What happens if you don't? If you make it, you made a commit and you want to undo it, like what's her name asked. Well, we can look in the log and see what has changed. So we can say git log dash dash one line, and it basically tells us that we have these these commits that have been made. Now if you start counting from the bottom, we go 0 1 to, so it's 0 1 2 3 4, right? Even though there's five of them. So if I wanted to go back to this one, all you would do at that point is do a git revert and say head. And then you use the tilde, and we want to go to number 3. And which one did I hit? to that one. All right. So let's go to this one. All right, let's see here. It says it cannot merge because we have unmanaged files. So let's do a git status. So we are going to do a git remove file text. All right, and if we do git status, everything now looks peachy again. And if we do a git commit, enter that username again. Everything should be reverted. All right, so now if we go back to GitHub, and we do a refresh, we can see now that we are now back to the beginning where there's nothing here. All of our files, the ones we added, have been removed. And with that, we have come back to the where we started, where it was just the stuff that we created at the very beginning. Now, I hope that this has been informative. If you do have questions, hit me up on the Slack channel and we would be able to respond to those questions.